Hello, 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 and welcome back to another episode of Made in the Abyss, lads. Now, you might have noticed a gigantic jump in everything between last episode and this episode. Last episode, at the time of recording, has not come out, and it has been a long, very long time since I have seen it. That is completely on me. I kind of went on a behind-the-scenes hiatus on solo reactions. That is on me. But right now, I just finished watching episode 5, I think, of season 3 of Dr. Stone. I was like, you know what? Table's out. I can put Made of an Abyss up on the TV instead of on my computer. I think I'm going to try to do this again. So, yeah, honestly, it was not Made in Abyss's fault. It was my fault. And if you're watching this now, you probably didn't even notice like this gigantic gap. For me, it's been a while. But the only thing you've noticed is the table, microphone, basically the entire setting, the way I film it, changed instead of it being on my computer, which I prefer to edit it this way. But yeah, you know what? It's on me. This series, from what I remember, it's actually really, really good. And I've just been wanting to get back into it. So yeah, last episode, I know that Rico and Reg, we finally made it into the Abyss. We found out about Rico's mother. She was one of the most legendary people to go down into the Abyss. We have the Curse of the Abyss. There's several symptoms that it can cause, which I have 1 through 6 written down, but I don't know what 3 and 5 are. I don't think the show has explained it. I don't know if the show explained it or if I just missed it. We're on a mission to find Rico's mom. What is in the Abyss and all of that. That's what we're going for. From what I can remember. So I'm sorry for like this really big hiatus on my end, but if honestly, let's just get right into this. Please bear with me. If I forget something, I will I try to remember it as soon as I will try and remember what I've missed, but I think I've got all the important parts down. I don't know if we're going to meet anyone back from the surface again. I know we had like a couple friends, like the orphanage and all that. I don't know if we'll see them again or if we're just going to spend all of our time in the Abyss. But let's just see where this goes, shall we, lads? I'm really interested to see what the lower levels of the Abyss look like. I remember I was like super curious about all of this. Did he get tangled up in his own arm? Oh, he made it so like they can, okay. He made a safe place for them to sleep. Give him a little slap on the face. I guess I couldn't help myself. It's a pretty cool, like, warning system, but man, if you gotta recoil at all, it's gonna take a while. The Depths, first layer, edge of the Abyss. So we're still in the first layer.
It seems so much brighter here than up on the surface.
I really like the setting.
Over there!
Like, look at that.
It's the rock arc! Is it because the distortion is carrying the light downward?
They're both nerds. I was gonna say, what do they eat? But I guess they could hunt stuff here. If it's even edible.
Ta-da! My special Rico soup is ready to enjoy!
Irredeemable.
The direction of the needle doesn't move a bit. Wait,
so
really?
It just points down. Interesting.
Is that thing even useful?
Yep, that's what I thought. Yeah.
Oh. Reg, did you make off with this? At the time, I thought I really had.
Oh, he gave it to them, huh? Is he just like calling her out for like, I knew you were gonna go here.
I'll depart at dawn to come capture you.
Reg,
do you have any idea how long it's been since dawn?
So he's coming.
I don't. Oh God, what do we do?
That's cute. You gave him a little warning.
If we get to the second layer.
Oh, I'd be holding on to something a lot more firm than a branch. Oh boy, a monster of the abyss. Oh, it's disgusting, I love it.
It's the second layer, the forest of temptation.
That looks like a mouth, man. That looks like a mouth. What's that sea monster, like that of like Greek mythology? It's like a ship goes in and just like, whoa. Memories. Did someone find them? It was like a monster looking at them.
But they're heading directly for us.
No, it's probably not a cave raider.
What? We even made sure to.
It's the third person in your party.
If you're taking the trouble to head down this way off the main route. Look up there, right?
That doesn't look human.
How's that possible?
Oh, never mind. Yeah.
Ah! Oh, they've caught us.
You're pretty fast, aren't you now?
Uncle Hobbo? Why are you
here? Okay.
How about that? Well, now.
But I'm sure with your speed, so you can catch all.
You're saying Reg is an honest to goodness treasure of the Netherworld.
Yeah.
Boom!
Then I'll go. I've had my look at the treasure of the Netherworld, so I'd better fulfill my promise to your friends. Let's get to hoofing.
I was gonna say, he's leaving already.
Seeker Cap. Pretty clever of him, really. Well. This is your final lesson. I won't get in your way.
But he's leaving already.
One last time.
What is this thing?
It's a vaccine for the second layer that Blue Whistles and Up takes. It should spare you from picking up the main illness down there. And also,
second layer would be headaches and nausea, I think.
Steam buns. Eat them before they go bad.
He's such a good guy.
All right, off you go. But if you dawdle too much, I'll become a white whistle and catch up with you, you hear?
He's a good guy. I hope I don't eat those words, but I like him. He's a good guy. It's such a meaty sound effect, whatever that thing retracts.
Did we actually just get away from all the cave raiders? Totally! We don't have to worry about anyone chasing us anymore!
Well, you could worry about that.
Now we're free to be pursued by all kinds of things that exist outside the realm of man.
Oh. That was it. Now I'm gonna watch another episode.
Did we actually just get away from all the cave raiders? Totally! We don't have to worry about
anything. I mean, they were going after them. Seems too easy. That they got away from those cave raiders.
We should get moving, Reg.
They are the outsiders. The enemy. The prey.
Enemies.
The threat.
I have no enemies.
I hear a voice. But not like the
It's
before.
A trap.
Let's go!
It's gonna be like
somebody needs our help.
Like a parrot.
Really?
I don't know. Could it be the people that came after them? Like, they got themselves into trouble? Oh! Well, it wasn't a trap.
That's a cave raider laying down on the ground.
That's really cool looking.
I think that thing is a corpse weeper. They mimic their praise cries for help to lure
us. It was a trap! Oh. This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them. And intro. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's actually cool looking. A corpse weaver. Sacrificing it. Oh, there's a ton of them. Where did they come from?
Oh, she's being fed to the chicks. This feeling. My body remembers this.
Right, he's gaining some memories back.
I did something like this before.
Oh yeah, the laser in episode 1. Don't hit Rico. Ooh. Rest in peace, those little chicks. Oh man! Oh my god. Bruh.
Right? Hey!
Why are you blushing?
Oh, Rico, you wouldn't wake up earlier. I got really worried. But you should
That's why you're blushing, dude.
You don't really need to act so embarrassed around me. You're a robot boy. Besides, you're the one who swooped in and saved me from certain death.
Bro got friend zoned in a different species. Bro got species zoned. I guess if a robot, it counts as a species, but.
Did you do this, Rick?
Sorry, I accidentally sneezed.
I've lost myself in the moment.
It must have come out of this thingy here on your hand.
This thingy?
Give it a name. Like
the Unibeam. That's taken.
I think we should call it that. So it was around. This bigger so, yeah?
What are you talking about?
The size of the blast. This great power you have here. You can master
if he can master it. Oh boy, ain't nothing gonna mess with him. But I assume it takes a lot of power. And we lost Reg. It was an unfortunate casualty that the Abyss took from us.
Feeling fine now.
That's great. Good to hear.
I forgot if he's solar powered. I think he just needs to eat to get like energy again.
The book you're always drawing pictures in, right?
Yeah. I guess I must have dropped it when that corpse weaver snatched me up and tried to eat me.
If that's the case.
Oh. Yeah, you're not getting that back. Those corpse weavers are really cool.
I tried roasting it under some oba leaves, and well, now they're able to once again lend us some of their strength. And that is
it's the circle of life.
All the other cave readers have been able to grow so strong.
It's like, what, everything that comes from the Abyss so returns
that
to it?
That I saw in my nightmare.
No, thank you. I saw something that looked like a giant wasp in there. I am good. Oh, that's actually really, that's a really good idea. That's really cool. Man, with him around, it's just like, navigating this is just easy mode. Those arms are so useful for so many things.
The wind down here is blowing like crazy.
Dang. I guess we can't water that flows up. Like we have been. Just as I said it was on easy mode, dang it.
It feels a little colder here.
And they say chivalry is dead.
It's so warm. It's gone.
Monkeys!
They don't look happy.
Has anything in the Abyss ever looked happy to you, my friend? That's so cool. Rest in peace, that guy.
You sure that's the way we're supposed to go?
Yep. We should be able to see the route to the Seeker camp soon.
Alright, just the thing that they drop, the thing that always points down, it's perfect for this area.
Master.
Master's already gone.
Better here. The wind's calmed down.
Master has gone to investigate themselves.
Central part of the Abyss. You see, long-range visibility is better where the force field is weaker. Hmm. So they ended up constructing a big old fancy telescope.
Rico?
Is that the telescope that you're talking about? Oh, okay.
Whoa!
Bang.
I think I managed to
Is there a problem, Reg?
Did he grab the girl?
So it seems she's alive. That little imp.
Seems that she's alive.
The immovable sovereign, Ozan the immovable. Or instead,
I like the shape of her whistle. Okay, I feel like we didn't learn too much about this, like, the last two episodes. It's more of, like, an adventure thing. Which, it's cool to see, like, what's going on, but it's kind of hard to, like, talk about like stuff without like major plot progression, especially since like we don't know too much about these characters. Now the new white whistle, which I already forgot her name, is like something the immovable. She said, "So you're alive." Which she could, she's probably talking about Rico in general, because she said like you're alive, you little squirt. I don't think she said squirt, but like something along those lines. So I think she's talking about Rico in that sense. She probably hasn't even seen Rico since they got her back up. And which is something I forgot, that Rico was born in the Abyss. So the immovable person has probably not even seen her since they got her out. I thought at first it was maybe implying the mom, but interesting. It could be that she's saying that because she could see them from like her vantage point, but it's interesting that she says that when she's holding the robot hands, like, oh, so you're alive. But it could be that she already knew that Rico was there. But it makes me think that she has something to do with Reg. Like, why would she say that while, like, looking at the robot hands? I could be looking too much into it. We got to the second layer, which we're kind of going at a faster pace. I know that there's two seasons and a movie. I know I need to watch the movie before season two. But I wonder how fast we're going to go down the abyss. Like, let's say we're at mid-season. I know, like, technically we have, like, one more episode till mid-season. But episode 6, we're still going to be in the second layer. I don't know if we'll travel down by then. But I wonder, like, what the pace of the show is going to be. Are we going to get to the bottom layer by the end of season 1? And then season 2, we'll be exploring the bottom layer? Or are we going to get, like, I don't know, layer 3 or 4 by the end of season 1? I don't know what the movie will be about. And then, like, season 2 will be about more of that. I don't know. All I know about season 2 is, like, it's a massive... like, not step up, because season 1 is, like, I'm enjoying season 1 a lot. It's just, like, not, like, the typical reaction format. It's more intrigue and mystery, so it's not like, oh, this happened, oh my god. It's more, oh, okay, that's what's going on, all right, yeah, see. So, I'm enjoying season 1, but from what I've heard, season 2 is a massive step up in, like, the lore of the Abyss and all that, so I'm really excited to get to that. I'm just... curious of like what the pacing of this is gonna be. So we're at the second layer. Before we got to the second layer, cool uncle. I'm just gonna say I like the uncle. He's pretty cool. I completely forgot about his character. I hope I don't eat those words. I hope he doesn't have like any ulterior motives, but I think he's just a chill guy. He seems like a cool guy. I like him a lot. He's a really nice guy. He's like, oh yeah, I came here to check up on the robot, but yeah, I'll help you get to where you need to go. And then he was completely understanding, too, of the whole test thing. He's like, all right, well, stay safe, kids. The leader's lesson, it's a little weird. It's a little bit weird of a lesson. But it has to be that, because, like, by putting the note in, he's implying that, yeah, I know you're going to go to the abyss. I'm going to stop you. I'm going to catch you. But go ahead and try. So I guess it is, like, a lesson. But that's also pretty cool of the leader. If the leader, I think the leader is the guy. I know there's two like prominent adult leaders. There's the guy and then there's the woman. I think it's the guy that they're talking about as leader. I don't remember what his name was. And to be honest, I don't think that this is I haven't seen it in a few months thing. This is a I do not remember names thing. I think they're talking about the guy. I remember he had like a conversation with Rico, in episode 3, I think, where he was like telling her about her mom. He seemed like a pretty cool guy, like a pretty chill guy. So it's interesting that this is like, they take it as a lesson. It's interesting that if this is a lesson, this is what he's going for. I take it more as a thing of, I'm going to let you explore a little bit, but I have to bring you back. I can't let you do, like, on my good conscience, I can't let you do that, go through with this. Unfortunately for him, they were too slow, because my gosh, Reg is such a cheat code when traveling the abyss. Those arms are so useful. His thing, like his pulley system, where he's like one arm grabbed onto here, the other one here, and we're like just retracting this arm while this one stretches. That's such a good idea. It's just, like, the amount of time it would have taken, if it was possible at all, for a regular explorer or regular whistle to have gone down there, or not gone to go across that, it probably wouldn't have even been possible. They would have gone like all the way around. It would have taken them forever. Reg is just like, all right, even with things that like aren't that aren't that bad, like that mudslide. It was like a hill, like about, you know, like. This angle, it isn't even that steep. It's like this angle, like, all right, we're just gonna like hold onto the tree and like, it's like, this is ridiculous how useful that is. And I love that they like play to the strengths. It's not like, oh, well, no, like, we can't do this. Like, no, like, it's like, oh no, arbitrary reason why we can't do this. Or like, oh, my arms aren't working right now. Like, my arms decided, like, they're gonna, like, malfunction at this point. It's, no, we can do this. We're gonna use this to the max capacity. Anything else, like, any other, like, anything that's gonna, like, inconvenience us, it will be an inconvenience. It's not gonna be this made-up thing of, this made-up tension. Like, oh no, my arms, they stopped working for some reason. It's, oh no, that monster is going to attack us and eat us. I need to find out a way how to defeat, or how to get out of the situation. Which, the big laser, I forgot until he started going like, there's something happening to me. I forgot that in the first episode, he saved Rico by shooting, I think it was like a giant flying snake with his laser, or scaring it away. So if we can learn, if he can learn how to control that, once again, easy, easy cheat codes. No monster would want to fight them. Like, that spider thing was disgusting. Just imagine, ugh! No spider. Like, I really likes the corpse weaver. Not only do I just really like the sleek white design, I don't know why that looks really cool, but I really do like the idea of it mimicking the voices of its victims that are long dead as a trap. At first I was like, this is definitely a trap, and then I saw like it eating the guy. I'm like, oh, maybe it's like this is like his last moments. But no, that guy was like long dead, and it's just playing them like a fiddle. It's a really cool creature design, and the eyes are cool too. Like, they're weird too, because it has like one eye, like where one would normally place, and it has like one eye in the middle, but I don't think it has an eye on the side. It doesn't have three eyes, it has two eyes. It's a really cool design. The spider thing was just like a horrendous looking spider. The snake I also really liked back in episode one. I really want to see more of the creature's design. And, like, there's the monkey things, which just look like wonky proportioned monkeys. So I want to see more, like, of the creatures and, like, their design within the Abyss. They said, like, there's, like, safe points within the Abyss. Like, where the light narrows is where a lot of the creatures focus their attention on, because that's where all the resources are. But the further you get out from that, the less aggressive, or like just the less amount of creatures you'll find, and the less aggressive amounts of creatures you'll find. Because like the aggressive creatures are fighting for resources, but like we saw that lizard thing all the way out there. And it's just, it's really small, basically harmless. It could probably like survive off of like eating some leaves or some small insects. Whereas like the bigger creatures are like, all right, we need to fight for survival. We need to like attack whatever. They're very, very territorial. And Rico said some things just don't leave their territory. So they have like a radius area that they will not leave no matter what, which is interesting. Makes me think like there's a magic system going on. Or like when she said that at first, it made me think like a magic system happening. Like this creature only has this area that it can go through. And like if it tries to go like boom, like there's like a force field that doesn't allow it to go through. But anyone else can pass. But it seems like the creatures or the monsters are just like programmed or instinctually maybe to just not leave whatever area they have marked as their territory. Maybe because like other creatures will just quickly swoop in, or it's just really hard to get territory within the Abyss, or both. I don't know. It's an interesting system for these creatures. I want to see more of the lore. Like Rico, I like how Rico is like so dedicated to the job, like her goals. Like when she was giving her speech, I like the characters, but it's the lore of the show that I'm like, all right, yeah, character's cool. I need answers. What is the Abyss? Why does it look like a monster? Or like, why does the Abyss itself, like when they show the map, I think it's in the opening, like they show the map, like here's the city, like this is the city that they live on, and then like the Abyss is like this gigantic worm looking thing, looks like a vortex like, with a body. I'm like, I need to know what that is. Like, yeah, Rico, cool. Give me the answers. So yeah, basically, like, this series is me gonna go characters, fun. When are the answers gonna come? When are we gonna more? When is the more lore gonna come? The only other thing that I can possibly think of to talk about is poor Reg getting friend zoned as being no. It's like, oh, I'm sorry. It was like, does this bother you? Like, you're a robot. Nah. Poor guy. Nah. Rico exploding. It's an interesting dream. The explosion looked like she was mechanical. So, like, could that be Reg imprinting himself on her? Like, when she blew apart, it looked like her eye was a mechanical eye. But it could just be stylized, or it could be hinting Reg's connection to her. I think the leading theory is that her mom made Reg for whatever reason. And, like, he has memories of stuff that he can't remember. So, like, what are his memories hiding? And why did he have the dream? I mean, obviously, like, the reason why he had the dream of Rico exploding is because he was worried about her dying. If he had missed his gigantic explosion, she would have been caught in the blast. So he's worried about her dying or killing her. He doesn't want to lose her, and he definitely doesn't want to be the reason why he loses her. But the explosion, the way she blew apart, that's made me curious as to why they chose specifically like that. I could be looking too much into it. I don't know. This series is really intriguing. So far, I don't think I don't think the meatiest of discussions have been had yet. But I can see the potential of the lore. Like, what's going on? What's happening? And that's what I'm most interested in finding out about this show. So, lads, if you want to see more, if you want to see my journey into the abyss, make sure you subscribe, leave a comment, all that. Notification bell. Leave your comments down below. How are you enjoying Made in the Abyss? I'm going to assume that you've already seen it up until this point. So, tell me if you can remember what were your thoughts of these two episodes when you're first watching it. Leave all your thoughts down below. If I got anything wrong, as long as it doesn't spoil anything, feel free to correct me. And I'll see you all in the next one. If you want to see more Made in the Abyss, like earlier, check out our Patreon. If you can't afford that, completely fine. Next week, there'll be another episode of Made in the Abyss just for you. So yeah, we're diving deeper into the abyss. So if you want to see layer 3, make sure you subscribe. Bye-bye.